lined up for the premiere of J. Edgar. And guess who's coming? It's going to be Clint Eastwood himself in just a few minutes. Now, standing by with me is Kevin McCarthy. A lot of you morning viewers know him as our movie reviewer. And just last week, Kevin, you got to interview Leonardo DiCaprio.
To chat with them while they're making.
Did you try to get a cameo?
No. when I was a young prosecutor, I had a couple of meetings with Jack Cooper. So I'm going to be interested in how they portray it.
I think that every time I listen to a debate, each side is trying to scare their potential supporters into supporting them more. And we also see, in our elected officials who are already elected, in order to win their fights, they fan the flames of fear. And I think that it's very dangerous. I don't think it's helpful to us as a nation, and certainly it's dangerous in that people have become willing to give up their civil liberties. Mm-hmm. So we got to make sure that stops.
Well, I don't think he was a cross-dresser. So that was one of the things that got shot down early in the research. But I do think that there was a lot of research on his mother. His mother was, really, she lived right over there, not far from here at all. And she really wanted to be invited to events just like this, but her husband was mentally ill. And so at that time, you couldn't just come, for the most part, as a woman to an event like this. You had to be on someone's arm. And at that point, she decided to make her new man her youngest son. And that was easier because she saw that he didn't feel comfortable loving, didn't feel comfortable having a family, that there was something in his nature that was keeping those things from him. And sadly, instead of encouraging him to go find love, which would have been very brave in her time, I admit, she did discourage it. And so, I think whenever a parent tells their child, you will never love, you will never have a family, and if you do, you'll bring great shame to me and to us, I think that hurts the child. And I think the child will turn to things to fill that hole, and things in Hoover's case, like political admiration, things that should be fleeting. And they'll do things that are dangerous in order to hold on to that admiration.
And last question, did you end up liking him or not?
I ended up feeling for him in certain ways. I feel like a lot of what happened to him in his youth was very wrong and hurtful. In the end, we all make choices. And it's up to us. We have to make sure we're staying true to our moral compass, and I think he lost his way. So, it's like the film. You have to come to your own conclusions. It's not all black and white. There's a lot of gray in there, and that was the goal with this film, was to finally try and tell a story from an unpolitical perspective, without an agenda. And in understanding him, hopefully we can prevent more Hoovers in the future.
Thank
back
you.
Out here, I'm staying with my mom down in Virginia, and I wanted to walk all of his old footsteps. So from his childhood neighborhood, sadly his home is gone, but to his adulthood home, and of course the Department of Justice.
That's in the current.
I might go get a cocktail.
Yeah, or that you would like to see.
What is it called?
Everybody.
DuPont.
I haven't seen it. I've got to listen. I don't want to. We're a year away.
You're not making any choices yet.
There's a lot of nice people, good people, throwing their hat in, and there's a lot of good people on the Democratic side too. I suppose if the incumbent, Mr. Obama, is the guy, and then he'll be supportive. Hillary will come back in. So I don't know. I like Newt's still the smartest guy in the room, but we'll have to see what happens. I don't know in the end. I think he was. I think he did a great job of developing the organization, and once he had the organization developed, I think he ran it in a very small group of people around him. He's both hero and he's people a lot of things. I don't think you can categorize it. But he was definitely had idiosyncratic type fellow. He was. I don't know. He's still a mystery to me, even though I liked him. I like dealing with him. making him into a live character. And then we'll see. There's not too many people who remember him firsthand, so we'll have to see what they think.
John Aaron, of Washington Life. Yeah, one quick question. What was it like shooting regionally here in Alexandria and Fauquier County, where you spent a lot
great.
Of time?
It was great. Yeah. I've always had good luck filming back here. I ran through the streets here in the line of fire as a Secret Service man, and one of my branches of the service that I belong to. Yeah. And so that was always fun. But people have always been very nice here, and working over in Maryland, they were equally nice.
Thank you.
So your name was floated as a vice presidential candidate at one point by the Bush administration.
Yeah, I didn't know they were that smart.